should probably see who's on Discord.
We've linked our territory to our allies.
Full power to maneuvering thrusters.
We're losing the adjust.
Picking up enemy contact. Over there. Enemy missiles incoming, Captain.
Shield activated. Full power to maneuvering thrusters.
I didn't get that kill. What? That's junk.
We've linked our territory to our allies.
Full power to maneuvering thrusters.
On our position. Our fleet has secured control point Alpha. The enemy team is about to win. We need to push them back.
Ships hull down to 50%, Captain.
We're in need of some assistance.
Damn it.
Abandon ship. All hands to evac system.
I've got no anti-missiles on this ship. That is a problem. Both points, we're gonna win.
We've lost our link to Allied territory.
Bueno.
The enemy is capturing control point Alpha.
Full power to maneuvering.
Dude, there's three of you right around there. Do not let that happen.
The enemy has captured control point
Alpha.
Are
you kidding me?
Our fleet is securing control point Alpha. Enemy warheads locked on our position. Goliath locked. Drain torpedoes locked onto contact. Drain.
Multiple impact. Damage control teams on station.
How the hell is he doing that much damage to me?
Maneuvering thrusters.
All vessels. We've got an enemy contact.
Shield activated.
That got him. Enemy destroyer, destroyed, Captain. Thanks, Captain.
All stations, stand down. This one's over.
Let's see here. Not so good. This build a different setup. Mm. lasers will be fine. Thank you. Let's see who's inviting me. Alicia's inviting me. Okay. Hey, what's shaking?
Hey, you want to do a veteran or legendary?
Whatever's popping.
Hold on one second, guys.
I don't have any legendary going, but
I don't see a lot of people on for legendary. It used to be that everybody that could play legendary I had in my friends list. Now it's not true, which is good, but I still don't see a lot of people on.
Whenever you guys start, let me know.
Could tell people to queue legendary and try it.
Generally, the best way to start that is to do a vet, and then at the end of the match, say everybody queue legendary.
That's actually a good idea.
That way, you're jump starting with like at least 6 to 8 people.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I am back. I can do legendary if you guys want to do that.
By the way, why we still have the launcher after we we explain the start?
I'm sorry, what's the question? Say one more time.
Well, basically we still have the launcher here at the back after you press start in Dreadnought.
Yes. You're asking why does it still exist?
No, not really. I mean, we press start and just 1 second, please. I have one issue with the computer right now. I mean, when we play Dreadnought, but the launcher still remains on it.
Correct.
Didn't close down.
Correct. Same as Battle.net does.
Battle.net.
Battle.net.
Yeah, a lot of games do that where just the launcher stays up while you play. I don't think it's negatively affects anything. At least not on my computer.
The launcher sometimes crashes. By the time we get to Steam, that'll be a totally different version of the launcher. And the launcher won't actually be used for downloading anymore. Steam will be the mechanism by which everything is just all bits are distributed.
I'm so excited for that.
But the launcher will still exist. It's real estate for us to promote stuff, and eventually that launcher will have not 3 pieces of content, but probably closer to 16 to 20 pieces of content in it.
Nice.
All right. The launchers are very important tools. It's not about this exists or not. The problem is not closing down. When you press starting game, it's still there.
I know, that's intentional. That's my point.
Well, what's the point of remaining there open?
Because when you quit, if for some reason, let's say you crash or what have you, you will be able to just hit start again.
I still have that issue. I got it. So you can easily start again.
Correct. And eventually, it will also be, again, an area where we're promoting things. So whether it's new content or patch notes or maintenance window announcements or what have you, by having it up, even if it's in the background, you're going to see it more often. And hey,
may
Jamie,
I suggest you something informally? I could write down if you want and send you for ticket like or forum ideas, whatever you just say.
Feel free to send it our way.
Maybe when you hit the button for playing, minimize near to the clock, something like that.
Minimizing is something we could possibly do.
Minimizing automatically for the system tray.
Yeah.
It would be very nice to have that option to activate and deactivate.
I have to see if the new launcher has that ability. We'll be moving from what's called Direct 4 to Direct 5 with Solid State Networks.
I don't know if it has that ability or not. We'll see.
That's easy to implement, but could be blocked or have issues with crashing the launcher if it does have any problem with coding, for sure.
Yeah.
If it's going to cause any problems, maybe not implementing such idea, such useful tool will be the best.
Yeah. Understood. Are we queued? Should we queue?
Well, let me know when. My computer is asking for restarting anyway. But I could do that very, like, less than 10 seconds if you give me that.
Flexible.
Alright.
You guys cool if I load up Team Deathmatch? Everyone ready?
All good.
Yep, handset here.
Okay. Awesome.
And at the end of the match, let's all of us sort of put in chat, hey, let's queue Legendary after this. The more of us that say it, the more people will trigger and move over.
Agreed.
People are not very often here. Does they use another program or software? Like, the, most of the guys are playing or playing something, but not here at the chat. Are they having their own clans and own servers?
Oh, why aren't there people in Discord?
Yeah, for example, some of the guys of BGV and on other squads, they are playing Dreadnought, but they are not here.
Yeah,
definitely
a lot of
They have their own servers. Most of the clans do.
Yeah. I like to come over here when I can, just to encourage you, you know, try to get other people to join Discord, and you can meet people that way. It's kind of nice, but
like,
we also have...
It's pretty much organized right now. They should join. I mean, kind of reunite and clans here. It'd be nice. See how many people are really playing.
Yeah. Yeah, I would love if more people got in Discord.
So we are talking about other voice options at the moment.
Okay. Yeah.
Tim, what night is the party again? I forget.
And I think Discord is a great tool, but still missing some stuff. Like, they should make the overlay easier and simple.
Yeah, I haven't had the overlay work on my Discord for, like, at least Dreadnought. I think it might still work in some other games, but it's been quite a while because it used to work.
There are some claims about here on this server that another day the guys, here is working fine for me, but we don't even know if the guy's paying the Prime or something like that.
I might try and make it over there. That's also the same night as the Wedbush Intel networking event.
We also missing some stuff we have now for the organizing list of players,
which is crucial.
The main tabs, this available offlines, and so on. You could even implement more, kind of. Depends about the level of stuff you have. You plan that, you can implement it. But we have no such things for the server. So for example, if you are signing up for 100 servers on Discord, and you don't have such tabs or reducing tabs for playing, like, Dreadnought servers. All the servers you are signing in for Dreadnought, in a simple tab with Dreadnought server.
Yep.
And another game, maybe Daylight or something like Service for Daylight. And we don't have such stuff. Possibly they're going to implement, because I see some news on Discord forum, and they have such ideas implemented already, very well voted. And things apparently not moving on the direction where it's supposed to be, the useful tools and stuff. So they going forward, the things are making heavier and how can I say, source hungry, isn't it? So that's very bad.
Yeah. Give me one second, guys. I got to step out of squad for a second. I got to respond to some people in stream. 1 minute. So Tim, I'm saying. So Tuesday night is also the Wedbush Morgan Intel networking event, which is probably the most important event of the week for me. short of dinner I'm having Wednesday night with a prospective new client that is kind of important as well. I have RSVP'd, yes, for the event. I'm going to try and get there, but I'll probably get there late, if that makes sense. Shoot, this is not the build I wanted. Oh, yes, this is the build I wanted. Yep.
Yeah,
right.
Dan is streaming too, so.
Cool. Oh, is it true?
Back. Sorry. It's hard to respond to people in stream. With my music and Discord chat and other things going on, so I had to step out for a second to answer a few questions. Yep.
I'll be right back.
Alright, thanks, Tim.
I didn't see that guy coming your way, Dan. My bad.
Hi, Captain. Engaging.
Captain, we're gaining.
I saved you. Kind of.
That was close.
Hey, Svenis.
Yes.
Do you know if they're planning on changing Defeat Measure so that it doesn't remove buffs?
It is changing many things. Many ways.
I just noticed that it didn't say that was something it did in the description.
No, that is not intended, and that is something that is being discussed as well.
Nice.
But Desperate Measures is probably not going to be doing what it does today. It's going to be doing something different.
Ah. Because it kind of almost gives you a second life.
As it exists, it's way too powerful.
It's nice in a Corvette, because I can usually get out of... But yeah, honestly, I'm pretty, since playing from early game, I'm pretty happy with the way the game is right now, but I feel like it's just continually getting better.
Good, thank you. That's exactly the hope. Slowly but surely. It's not going to be overnight, but we'll get there.
I'm sure you guys don't always hear very much positive feedback, so.
Never. No, and that's actually I'm being unkind. We've actually been getting more and more positive feedback, so I'm, you know... Never overwhelmingly, never unanimously positive, and I don't ever expect that to happen, but I'm encouraged by the people who can see what we're doing and recognize what's happening. You know, in particular, there are a bunch of game devs at other studios that I talk to that are like, I see what you're doing. That's cool shit. And I hope you guys tune into the stream on Wednesday. I think we'll have some cool stuff to show you. I think it's 1 p.m. Central, I think. Okay. But we're going to show you the new UI. We're going to walk you through it in live.
Oh, yeah.
In current state.
It would be very nice if you can relocate and we have magnetic sides for chat and position it then in the proper way. It's not like over... Post the one over another, something like that. Yeah, like overposted almost all the time, and also turning on automatically.
Yeah.
It's off discussion at the moment.
Need support fire at these coordinates. You're the boss.
Sending a repair system drain. Starting cooldown.
Starting recharge now.
As he done trigger, though, kind of beautiful to watch. I was coming in on that guy, and then you just take him out. But
picking up enemy contact. How am I only two kills? I feel like I've just been doing quite a bit of damage on people.
Yeah, I'm lagging with one of the missiles behind you.
No, I got it. It's slow missiles. That's one thing. Vultures. I really wish vultures were slightly quicker. But I'm sure it's not super fast.
Oh, I got picked on there. That I had three people on me there.
So weak.
But yeah, no, overall, I love this game.
Good.
Which tack can you mark it? Oh, I see it. Ravish Master.
I'm gonna get in close first. Maybe not close, but okay.
Corvette left side. Do you see that, Dan? I'm with you, by the way.
Enemy missiles incoming, Captain.
Warping into yellow, people!
Let's get him, Mike. Let's get him.
Alright, I got afterburners just a second. Afterburners.
Ooh, he disruptor pulse at me.
Yeah, same. Crap. There's some Harwich or something trying to beam me. Alright, 2 seconds and let's get out of here.
Being all sorts of mean.
Deploy repair pod, aye, Captain. That's it, she's done.
Oh, 32 hit points, got him, but then the Harwich beamed me the last touch.
We'll have to watch him, he's not bad.
When a tickle is enough to kill you.
We're taking him down, ship by ship.
Right?
I'm actually using 6,000 for the bitrate there.
Same.
I will definitely be going up above 6,000 as soon as I figure
out. Twitch will shut you down above 6,000, so be careful.
Nah, you can push it to 8,500 pretty easily.
What? They don't support 4K streaming yet, right?
No, they do.
They do?
Do they?
Because I can stream at 4K.
There's been a lot of us that have been doing that. Not me personally, but a lot of LRB.
Is Borg doing that?
I do believe he has been.
I would
not Borg has triple SLIs.
Borg's. Yeah, I would not mind Borg's setup. Yeah. Wonder what that guy does for a living.
He's retired, isn't he?
Yeah, I don't know. He has heated driveway, I know that.
That's the way to go. That's totally the way to go.
Yeah. I'm like, well, why is your driveway heated? He's like, it snows here. I'm like, oh.
Yes, it does in Utah, for sure.
That makes sense.
Did we just stomp those guys? I didn't even look. We should have been nicer.
Yeah. I felt like I wasn't doing that well.
How do I only have 3 kills?
I only have 5.
Venice was stealing them all.
I was.
Yeah.
But how I'm stealing them is going to change in 113 as well. Mostly.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
The question is, how are you stealing them?
Please, Strybog, please don't nerf the Strybog.
Yes, Strybog is getting nerfed. But not it has to be. Strybog and Netron. No, that shit is ridiculous. Let's be real.
Strybog is kind of weak, but when you put the kinetic weapon amp on, it's like god mode.
Kinetic weapon amp, desperate measures. I mean, there's 3 or 4 things that makes a guaranteed kill or 2 every time. It's ridiculous.
Yeah.
And it's unkillable.
I have to admit, like, if you're watching my stream right now, my Strybog is literally named the win button.
Yes. Yes. So that should
start to go a little bit bad.
Let's just say that shit is going away. Like, I'm not saying going away. It's going to be brought back into balance. There's going to be more counters to it. And this is the thing. We don't mind things that kill people. This game is about killing people.
Exactly.
Just because you kill people does not make a thing overpowered. It's when there's no counter to that thing and no counter to the counter, that's when there's a problem.
Purge beam.
What about it?
I think it counters that out pretty okay, but right.
But a purge beam is from in my opinion, what you have to give up in that slot to use it is a pretty massive give. So. You know, you have to have something pretty powerful in exchange for that, I would think. So Purge Beam kind of fits that bill. I don't know that that's one of the ones. Let's put it this way. We're going to be rolling through what we call our combat review roadmap. And there's an order of operations in which things are going to get addressed. The first thing is officer briefings across the board are being looked at. And you saw the first step with Adrenaline Shot in 112.1. In 113, there's going to be a lot more officer briefings that are, some are going to be buffed because there's a bunch of them out there that are just not, the downsides way outweigh the upsides. And then there's a number that are going to be toned down because we feel that they are, as currently built, not just good to have, they're must have. And we don't want to have any officer briefings that are must have. We want a number of different viable builds to come from things, not something that is so important to have or so central to a build that you can't do without it across a slew of ships. I think Module Amper is one of those that falls into those categories. I think desperate measures in certain cases on certain classes is one of those things. Now, mind you, I say this, I'm telling you what the conversations that the combat designers are having. I'm not making any of those decisions personally, but the feedback you guys give us and the data that we look at plays heavily into those decisions. Now, once we get through those, there are, I'll say, some problematic builds on certain ships. The Strybog, Netron have a number, more than one problematic build.
Real quick, did we say we were loading legendary, or did we forget?
I think we were supposed to, but we didn't. Yeah, we did. Okay. I said it. So let's cue legendary.
Oh, okay.
I'm gonna put a ping in Discord too.
Okay. Good job.
Sweet. I just want to make sure whether we're queuing.
No,
or legendary.
I said it at the end. And Falcon, to answer your question.
Okay. Cool.
There's a list of things, but I honestly forget what they all are.
Sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off there.
No, it's all good. I was just actually chatting with someone. Falcon asked me, besides what OBs are getting buffed, besides Glass Cannon, which is getting buffed. I shouldn't say it's getting buffed, really. It's just the downside is being removed, in effect. So there's no downside to
that
Glass Cannon moving
so
forward.
So much more viable.
Yes,
I don't really
exactly
know
right.
Who runs it.
Nobody does, for obvious reasons. So, I mean, there'll be some officer briefings that still have a trade-off, but the trade-offs won't be as negative. And there are certain officer briefings that won't be, I'll say, game-changingly awesome, but they'll have no downside. They'll only be a positive. And Glass Cannon is going to be one of those that falls into that category. And then we're looking at other things. Then once we get through the OBs, we have to go module. There are certain builds that are problematic, and then we have to look at some modules that are... missiles and torpedoes are probably going to get a complete overhaul as a system, because there are certain missiles and torpedoes that are, I'll say, they serve no purpose relative to
heavy torpedo, for example.
As an example. And then, cool. Hey, thanks for the raid.
I did notice that the heavy torpedo had less range than light torpedoes. There was less projectiles. And it did less damage.
Yeah, there's a number of modules that are fairly obsolete, but they...
You may see some modules get completely removed and replaced with something else. You may see... I'm trying to think of what else. And then we want to take a look at all secondary weapons, because some of the secondary weapons are just... absolutely pointless.
I would personally love more secondary weapons. I mean, I know that's a lot to ask for.
Maybe.
But
it's not out of the realm of possibility, but there are some systems that we have to build. Coming back to the missiles and things, like, for example, flechettes should be the same on every ship. It's not different damage, different ranges, different... if they're flechettes, they're flechettes. They should all operate the same way. Stuff like that's going on. And then we're talking about bringing back the concept of flat cannons as being able to destroy projectiles, the way that they were originally intended. Because right now, flat cannons were meant to be anti-corvette, but corvettes just stay outside of range of them and can still hit. So we're probably going to make some changes to flaks as well. Things like that.
That's a bot.
I got some ideas, but I'm not sure if they are going to be, like, easy or hard.
Right now, everything is hard. I'm just going to tell you right now, the way the tools work, the way the tech is built, the way everything...
I wish I could tell a lot of the newer players is, like, you know...
We have to build some systems.
Here since the beginning, these things take time. So, like, when you're like, I want the fixes, I want the changes, and I want them right now, it's... it's not necessarily something you can ask
Man, just don't think on this level, because I mean, everybody knows here pretty much how hard their things is, and there's no kids around here, so it's kind of cool.
Yeah.
It's the years of kids, yes. There's no kids around.
And it can seem, I think, a lot of people that there's a decent amount of people that I see complain, and to them they're like, it's, I don't know whether they just think people aren't working, but people are working and they've been doing a great job. So
thank you. Well, we're building a bunch of systems that are going to make things easier to change in the future.
Forget about that. It's nothing about that. I was just going to say about crossing the fires in line. We are just shooting line all the time. And how about we press one button who cross the firepower in like 25 degrees crossing lines. So it's gonna be like more abrangent in front of you. It's like, we have this principle implemented on fighters. We didn't shoot straight. They shoot in 20 degrees or less. 12, those 17.
That's something I'd actually love to see more of, is some more work with the way... Well, I think bombers are pretty good right now, but just to see... If you could have, like, a dreadnought, I don't know if you'd have to create a new class, but they had multiple bombers
fighter base.
Fighter slots. Yeah.
Maybe.
So that would be interesting.
Yep.
Hashtag
could be. It could be. It could also be cancer.
We'll see. It's got to play differently.
Yeah, exactly. But, you know, I think that there's a lot of possibilities. So. I love hearing about everything that's happening, though.
And storm missiles we got to fix as well. It's storms with desperate measures, with module reboot, with module amper. Basically, it's two kills every time minimally. There's no counter, unless you have a team countering, because you can anti-missile lasers will take out some of the first wave. Anti-missile pulse can take out an entire wave, but you get two more sets using those two in your build. So it's a guaranteed kill even on a dreadnought.
Hey Dan, where are you located? Okay, I'm gonna swing around to your side.
Oh man, Koku, thanks for the anti-missiles there. That was baller.
That's also a cancer build. The build my brother's doing.
Which is what?
He can't call what I'm doing quite cancer, because I'm not even running tier 5 yet. I'm running tier 4, but I'm in the Ordis build. The evasive maneuvers, nuke mine, blast pulse.
Yeah, that's gonna be nuked. That's gonna change. Evasive maneuvers will be broken. That's one of the things that is an unintended. You're not supposed to be able to use a module and stay cloaked.
Yeah, I mean.
And it's a perfect cloak, so we may or may not continue to make that a perfect cloak moving forward.
Yeah. I think the one thing that I think would make so much of this more of a counter, like, is put like a disruptor pulse on the destroyer. I mean, I know that would break a lot of stuff, but. Because honestly, that is like the biggest counter to any of these builds. Whether it's the Ordis build, the Storm Missile build, the Strybog, a Disruptor Pulse just ruins everything.
It doesn't, though. It won't stop Kinetic Weapon Amp.
It will?
I don't think it will. Will it?
It always pops, it tanks it off for me. Every time I get a Disruptor Pulse in the Strybog, it's like an automatic guaranteed, I'm going to die. Oh god, what happened?
Huh, interesting.
Yeah, that's something we could test.
It is the bane of my existence.
Disruptor pulses are pretty... They're pretty brutal.
I use disruptor auto beams on my Arties sometimes.
Aw, you just got purged too. That is just sad.
It's always like...
Yeah, you got that Vindi coming in on me.
We're kind of stomping. Let's slow down. I'm gonna go in and suicide, or go. I'm gonna go Tesla. Those dudes, give them a kill or two.
I don't know about you. I've been dying. I've been doing shit this round.
Yeah, but we're. I mean, you can look at.
Yeah, I know.
The score. We're kind of stomping. Keep it close so we don't kill the Q.
That's a good idea, actually.
I'm only 9-0.
Okay, be good.
Yeah. Maybe pull out a different. Damn, that's a pretty brutal setup, so maybe pull out a different one.
Let him get to at least 70.
That is a rammer. Oh, that was beautiful to watch. That was.
He got it all.
Okay, I'm just gonna sit here and not kill anyone, so I don't
want to
end it.
Oh, darn it. We ended it.
Yeah, that was kind of brutal. That was kind of mean.
Yeah. So general rule, keep it close, especially in Legendary.
Dan, especially in that build. Jesus Christ.
See, yes, it is.
I'm trying to level the Catarro, and it's the easiest way to get experience for it, but I don't even have tier 5 for it. That's what's, like, the funniest part. Like, I can understand the tier 5 with 15 seconds, but you only get 7, I think, for the tier 4. But yeah, I'll...
Why? I can't chat. How come?
It's a bug. Eventually click your mouse down in the button, but occasionally it'll never come back to you.
Oh, right. So, Dan, do you want to run something more like, ooh, I should throw my Lorica in. Do you want to heal for my Lorica?
I need to level the Catarro, but I'll just do, like, a Purge Beam heal instead of...
Yeah, I also need to level it as well. I'm gonna drop my Aeon out.
I think that is my new favorite module though, Svenis, is the Purge Beam.
It's a good module. Very useful. But again, it's, you know, a primary slot. It's weapon slot, so
I rarely run it. I like having my repair drone or my beam amp. I mean, it's a hard choice, because
situationally
really nice.
It's got good uses.
Depends on. Repair drones are so useful if you don't have a second healer. So it's hard to say. I usually take one setup with beam amp, one setup with.
They are drones. Very powerful too.
And that's what's nice, is when you have a slot where all your modules are fairly equal in power. Whereas, you know, there's some... I almost feel like Overclock Pulse could use a lower cooldown or something along those lines, because no one takes it. Or Cloak Pulse. Cloak Pulse has been used a little bit lately.
I'm seeing it more and more getting used. Yeah.
It's helpful to keep missiles off of you, but...
I think, yeah, it's one of those things where Cloak Pulse I see a lot used in squads. I virtually never see it used by solo players. Cloak Pulse with, like, an Overclock Pulse. Try to help reduce that cooldown. Not a bad combo.
I could totally, yeah. I feel like Overclock Pulse could use a lower cooldown.
Possibly true. I think the thing that's going to... What a lot of people are using Overclock Pulse for is stacking pods, and pods are going to get differently.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree with that too. And I suppose if you had a lower cooldown, you could have two people's Overclock Pulse keeping it just continually going.
Yep.
Yeah, with three Hang on, Luna.
I gotta turn your mic up. You're a little quiet.
Luna says nerf Bitcoin mining in the hangar.
Yeah, that'll change. That'll change in the new UI.
Oh, we got Jack on the other team. We got Spartan. All right, this may be a real match.
Oh, snap. Okay. Now,
Now go ahead and play whatever
no more
you
niceness.
Want. Man.
Yeah. Now kill them.
Yeah, they're gonna be coming in here just.
Oh, and Luna Jack. Ouch. That's a good team on the inside, Spartan.
Yeah, this is gonna be tough.
Yeah, how many day am I juggling here?
Enjoy the journey. Spartan. Spartan has every single module. I don't know how he does.
Oh wait, they do have bots. Okay, never mind. I thought they didn't have bots. We did.
Okay. Who do I want to purge first?
I've got disruptor auto beams up because I think they got
healers. Do we have healers?
We have fake healers, aka Katara. Just pod them, but anyway.
Yeah, I know. That missile's coming towards me. Where you at? Right there?
Yeah, they got a bunch of rammers coming in.
They're all
the disruptor.
There are like sharks just waiting right over there.
There's two sets of missile repeaters. Thank God for
back up a little bit.
Drain missile on Jack.
I'm being pushed forward by somebody. I can't back up.
Drains on Jack.
Never mind.
What? I got scrambled and flacked. Just as I hit my. He's right below you. It's Luna. God damn it, Luna.
He's cloaked. How did he get cloaked? He's in a bendy.
I don't know. I just hit my.
I got him.
Oh, that almost hurt.
Do you have an anti-missile pulse you can pop right now?
Yes.
I got disruptor auto beams.
We need to take care of Jack, because he's running his Corvette. I mean, not his Corvette, his healer.
I'm on him. He's about to be drained, about to be drained. Drained.
Hostile contact sighted. Jesus, they missed all three of my... Okay.
Jack's almost dead.
I just got scrambled again. I don't
Same. I just hit my disruptor. I just disrupted somebody.
Dude, where did he come from? I'm not seeing him approach at all. I'm being a scrub tonight.
God damn it. Me too. I'm not seeing him come. Otherwise, I'd disrupt faster. Luna's getting
Sorry,
it off
we'll,
and just
we'll
flacking
it
auto.
Worry.
Yeah.
I'll start keeping my proximity mines around. Aw, oh, shit. We got a dreadnought back here.
Oh, I just missed every shot. That was good.
You guys keep hitting that guy. I might be able to survive. Thank you.
Hey.
They're ahead of us, but I'm gonna keep my proximity mines out to the left of me.
I got nukes on me.
No, he's coming right, it looks like.
And I've got all sorts of missiles on me.
Jack over there. I'm gonna see.
I'm gonna get killed by missiles in a second.
Where you at?
Near Whoa, I lived.
Off.
Ooh, 658 health.
Jack right now?
Nice.
Got a bearing on the enemy ship.
Got him.
Did you get Jack? Ooh. Push.
Yep, Jack's down.
Luna's got the warp.
Luna's
he's
coming.
Warping through.
That's what he's doing. He's warping.
I'm taking a lot of hits here. I don't even know how. Alright, healer 2 is out here. I don't want to die, but I'm gonna see if I can get out fast enough. Aww, always die mid jump.
Yes, he got on my mines. Nice.
Activate exo shell, my captain. That's it for our exo shell. Recharging now.
Oh man.
Still not doing great, but
I'm gonna keep it. Happening on their tactical grid, right?
Spartan, alright. Jack is perched. Aw, they have double healer. Luna just went healer. That is not nice. Okay.
Hi, Captain.
Firing up. Now the problem, I will be right there.
Keep in Jack. He's halfway down. If anyone's got more, ah.
I am here.
Mike, do the anti-missile pulse. Pop it.
What player? I just got burned now.
You heard the captain.
Hi, Captain.
Can't see anything yet.
Understood. Reload
support fire. Need it over
here. How long does the,
recharging generator.
Alright, I just purged a bunch of them. Corvette incoming.
Enemy warhead locked on our position.
It's like forever.
Shield activated.
Hit this Corvette for a free kill.
Enemy contact.
You heard the captain.
So many missiles on me.
Watch out for any moves.
You're the boss.
These are a good match though. This is what I love about this game.
Owen's low. Ish. Now getting healed.
Yeah. Them and their healies.
The pod's in place. We've got nothing left.
Enemy warheads locked on our position.
Shield activated.
Got a bearing on the enemy ship.
Amplifying weapons, aye.
No, stop healing so much.
They have two Koshis. I don't know if I have a Koshi in my setup, but that might work. Make sure we're getting hit in their pods.
Enemy missiles incoming, Captain.
Alright, just got purged by Spartan. Somebody help! That's annoying. That's really annoying. Wow.
Reloading.
Captain, we're getting.
Has purged all their healers and everybody.
Enemy missiles incoming, Captain.
Hit Luna. Aw, weapons weakened right when I'm hitting Luna. That is not fair. They got me as a weapon breaker.
Enemy vessel.
Guys. Hello?
Hey.
Who that?
Okay, which missiles do I want to get hit by?
Owen's low. Ish.
All ships, enemy contact at this location.
Just went down.
Incoming, Captain.
Wowzers. What a match.
We're gonna try to farm their bots more, guys. They're really losing.
Bots.
No, I'm in trouble.
Really are.
Damn.
Hey, our bots are 0-5 and 0-4.
As I just. This...
Their bots are winning.
Yeah.
You know, for a little while, those bots were super overpowered.
Right now on.
It's like the head aim bots is kind of cool.
Nice. Good shot on Jack.
Hi, Captain.
There we go.
Setting a repair pod. Reloading.
They're trying to kill our bot again. I'm gonna try to keep it alive. If I can.
Heads up on Owen.
Got him.
Shield activated.
Nice.
Good job. Double kill.
Nice.
Playing it smart.
On Jack.
I just got purged. No, I don't want to die first.
Shield, Mike. What are you doing?
I can't shield.
I'm paying attention. That's what I'm doing.
Trying to keep you up, man.
That's still a good match.
Still had 10 kills.
Yeah, Svenis, did you guys fix the glitch where, like, the error... Well, not the error, I mean, but the fleet gets moved around. So your main ship in the front gets moved back second slot or something like that?
I don't know. I suspect that's a UI issue, in which case... All of that will go away come Steam launch, but that's an orbit issue, right? That's the problem?
Yeah, because my fleet just got rearranged again.
I suspect that won't get fixed until Steam launch, because the UI that's coming in 1.13 is everything leading up to the match. And then the other part, the other half is coming. The in-game HUD and Orbit and post-match screen are all being done by Steam.
Nice.
So Steam's taking...
Yeah. I'm going to grab a beer. Just a second. Back in a minute.
Nice. Think I can play like one more, Dan?
I'm so hungry.
Have the best ones, probably.
I concur, as a New Yorker who's transplanted to California for 25 years and now Texas.
Oh, man.
Now you eat Calango pizza, isn't it?
You know, I should probably get off after this next round and go eat some food. It's making me hungry. So I
can see what, I can see the guy at the kitchen throw it, a giant piece of pizza inside, throw it, put the fingers on it, and push to the truck. Get in. I'm hungry. The pizza isn't gonna work at this place. Use the fingers up. Get in. Go to the stomach.
Do I get Tartarus or
Bot Invasion Bug? No, Crafty, he didn't. What happened?
Pulse next. Or the, Gentleman. Everybody's in here.
Yep.
Who's everybody? Captain Ahab. Val.
Yep.
Yes, I am the world. And the world is me.
It's UI filled up with bots over and over again.
I can do one better.
Crafty, is that just in the leaderboard, the score table?
The rock on the wing.
If so, that's a known bug that gets fixed in the new UI. If not,
makes sense.
Different problem.
I wish you can customize ships, the calls,
yes.
At
yep.
least, so we can print our squads on it.
Yep. I've seen that before. It's what? Not common, but it does happen.
Customizable ships, the call. So can you print our squads on our own ships? Personalize the call.
The decals?
Personalize your decals?
Yes, the decals.
That's...
I think they want just a ton of penises.
Well, so heads up, we are looking at using...
Two servers, same shit, I can't believe it. I was in another service, the guys has the same idea.
We are looking at Steam Workshop for people to submit decals and things like that, and if it works well, we might be able to do other forms of content. That's in our roadmap eventually as well, but we're looking at... there are some things we need to do to the pipeline to enable that, but we will curate it. It won't be a free-for-all of anything anybody uploads goes in. We have to do legal passes and all that stuff. And plus, we
That's
want it to be
true.
High-quality stuff, not...
of course, but
not
could we legalize our squads? Could we like submit for proving before getting inside the game? personalize the decal or something like that?
When Steam Workshop happens, yes, that'll be a thing. But that is really, if we get it done towards the end of the year.
Hey, Kangaroo, thank you for the follow.
And if we get decals in, we can also start to provide specifications and tools for other types of content. But there are things that, you know, I don't want to get into too many details, just what else that could be. But we have hopes for, hey, we love user-created content. Hell, if it's content that we don't have to make and it makes the game better, we're all for it.
That's exciting.
Yeah.
I like that idea.
It's just personalized decal because, for example, we can imprint our decals from our squads on our ships. For example, mine is at Phoenix, so that could be like, well, I have already because I'm working with this kind of squad or teams or whatever the name is, like for another games for a long time, like more than 10 years right now. Mm-hmm. And, well, this works pretty crew, like a charm.
Right, yeah, what?
Kept spamming with squad invites till I literally deleted him off my friend list. Now he's spamming his friend invites.
It's just, very attractive for players.
Just friend him.
Be a part of something.
Friend him and whisper to him. I'm already in the squad.
Yeah,
that's what I do. And eventually, chat 2.0. You'll just be able to right click, respond to things, notifications. In the new UI, notifications are much more obvious. We have a whole notification, I'll say it, box. Like, think of it like a message box, practically. Anyway, you'll see it on Wednesday. It's on the stream. It's way better.
I want to watch this.
Will we be able to move around? Like, you know how you open up the chat box and everything? Will we be able to move that around instead of having it pop up in the same spot?
No. The way it works is different. The new chat window is different. It slides in and out, so it looks more like almost the way the squads work. It's a bit more modular in that regard, but it's still a fixed location. But it's not nearly as, I'll say, in your face on that. It's less obtrusive, and the other thing is you don't have things like your captain progression windows stacking up over it, constantly opening, like that all lives in a different place.
That's nice. Good.
Okay.
I know some ideas I have is not very welcome, but whatever, I'm gonna say anyway. I think the IE indicators for the ship are too much spread around inside game.
Damn.
We have a lot of content around the top. Rough.
That's okay. Right, they got Val, so we don't have to worry about anything.
I'm not equal to 5 LIBs.
Just kidding, Barry, you're really good, dude.
Well, for example, we have at the moment, the map's pretty bad, I'm sorry.
And
the map's too thin, we have a pretty map to dislocate. And we have the out at the top. We have the what's the name? The weaponry, glitch. Right? So it could be at the top of the boards, right side here, and there will be a great difference because you can straight look for the one place, and you have all the information inside the game, very accurate and precise. So. They are too much spread away around the screen.
I'm a wrong healer. I need to take this out of my healer setup. I have Borg's troll setup with overclock pulls and overclock module.
Wow.
In nuclear mines.
Well, I wouldn't go charging up to the front then. I would kind of try to stay behind me.
Well, I need to die.
So you can spawn.
Hey, just use all your modules on them so I can overclock you guys.
Here, come here, Vision. Come here.
Everyone hit Spartan.
Everybody go after Spartan.
Dan, let me know when you're ready for overclock. Please be ready soon.
We're losing power. I'm blocking my shots. Oh, hey, Val. How's it going, Val?
Oh, damn.
It's awesome.
I was.
Jack got me. With rapid fire.
No, Val, no, get back over here.
Alright.
I wanted to kill
Luke. Catapult locked. Hey, Illusion didn't want to come to me, so I came to Illusion.
Alright. Alright, just got hit with
the
squirt.
Need
support fire. These coordinates. That it is. It is. Yes. While. All these pods here are not helping.
They are. Sure. Very sure.
Picking up enemy targets. Alright. Over there.
Alright, I am...
Full power to maneuvering thrusters.
Warping it on...
Okay, one of their attack cruisers is down.
Hey Dan, I'm trying to heal Kakura.
Where's our healer at? Oh, hey, Val. You didn't just turn it. In Agora, you did.
I am about to get hit pretty hard. Ooh, not very nice.
Oh, not that at all. God damn it! I can't do that.
Oh, damn it. Jack got me again.
Away.
I did that on purpose.
It was mid jump. It was so.
They've got three healers.
Yeah. Yep, it's definitely hard. You got to sneak around and get them. I killed one of them,
very
but they're definitely hard. I'm dead now.
Hey, I'm just being friendly. I know you guys always like. Oh,
Jack just wrecks me.
Yeah, Jack is so.
Earth Jack.
Oh.
Well, that is not nice at all. Have some machine guns. About to die.
I can't see him.
Oh, yeah, you died.
As long as you died.
Oh!
You guy that keeps killing me, too. And it's none of you guys that keep killing me.
Damn it, Jack got me again. I so almost had Ahab there. I literally needed one more shot before reload.
Oh, the healer's dead! Yes! One healer out. I'm gonna... Oh, hey Val, how did you even see... Wait! When did you get there? That's my question. When did you get there?
It's called a warp. It's called a warping pillow. We've been hit hard. Damage control team dispatched. Fire thrusters. I forgot a bearing on the enemy ship. Oh. Hey, Genevieve. Shield
activated. Don't kill Jin. He's only... He doesn't know what he's doing. He doesn't know what he's doing.
Oh, he died.
Get Luna. Get Luna. He's up.
Mark your target. Mark what you want dead.
Support fire. Need it over here. Stasis. Hit up Jack's out. Hit up Jack. Stasis warhead
launched. Watch out, Purge, Dan.
Dang.
About to go down. Spartan got me. Got an enemy contact.
Fire on this target. Hey Val!
Hey.
There's no way that you're at this location. Thanks for the There you go. Oh come on!
You didn't
kill.
Kill me.
It was my kill!
The same guy that killed me.
God,
it's the same exact guy.
Not supposed to be.
Oh though. My gosh, that's hilarious.
Twice that happens now.
Oh god.
Oh god, I'm so upset. It's not happening to you. Three in a negative launchers reloading. Amplifying weapon.
Everything I have is tier 3 though.
Man, they scrambled like the entire time.
Yeah, it's kind of...
This does kind of get annoying, right?
Right.
I don't know why, but I am in my...
I'm getting purged.
General Stowe is almost dead. Jan Ebisu, get him.
Oh yes, I now have another healer, finally.
They have 3 attacks though, that's not good.
One of them's low.
Full power to maneuvering thrusters.
Nice.
One is down. There we go.
Enemy warheads locked on our position. Launching catapult. Evasive maneuvers, I guess.
Dang it, I just got scrambled.
We've got activated.
Anti-missile pulse engaged.
The space elevator to each one is amazing.
Picking up enemy contact. Over there.
We're running out of time, Captain. If we don't pull it together, we're dead.
Scrambled. Are those bombers that are scrambling us or what?
It seems like Strider Ward.
Yes it is.
Luna's coming right up top of me, Dan. I don't know if you can focus him.
You can't kill Luna. He's running bombers and armor amps, and you're just gonna feed his. Every time you guys shoot him, you're literally feeding his bombers.
Pretty much.
Jeez, this is rather a scramble, sir.
Well, if you want him to die, you have to kill the healer.
Yeah, well, obviously I'm a healer, so I'm not gonna do that.
Wow.
But if you would come down a little bit lower, Dan, I can,
Hey, Dire Bear. What's shaking, man?
Fail.
Finally!
I'm trying to not die, to be honest.
Full power to maneuvering thrusters.
Catapult locked. Stasis warheads got an enemy warheads locked on our position.
Dead scramblers!
Maybe come back something like... Oh, did you save your life, Tim?
Yeah, I'm double armor.
He got me too. You're out of a healer.
Picking up enemy contact. Over there.
Oh my god.
Oh, finally we got him.
Purges, stasis, or not stasis, disruptor type stuff.
Yeah. Something like a.
Oh
indie.
Man. Yes, getting wrecked. Well, I'm getting wrecked.
You guys need to change your position. You just stayed in the table position compared to ours. Your healers were exposed. Ours weren't?
Yup.
Hey Mike, I need to turn my AC on.
So go ahead, I'm gonna go eat some food and go to bed.
Alright, yours is off?
Yeah.
Cue.
Okay, I am back.
Do I get...
Good game, good, though, guys.
Very good game. Took you the whole match to kill me, Goro. And I was in a tier 4 too.
Me?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know.
Are you going to have any modifying for this map?
Everything I have is still...
Are you going to drop out?
Yeah.
I'm just making my way there. Do I get charters first, or what do I get next? Or the Jutland?
I did Tartarus first.
I personally on the Jutland, I don't know, I like my plasma broadsides.
Just Martin, my... Are you guys in the squad?
Yeah, right. It's just me, Jack, and Luna. That's it.
Okay. I will catch you guys later. Hey, good playing with all of you.
Likewise.
Yeah, good playing with you.
Yeah.
By the way, like, both matches you had two bots, which didn't help because both of them, RNG gave them aggressive rolls and they just kept suiciding and
yep.
That doesn't help out. And then, on specifically with the last one. In here?
It's me and Captain Ahab. Though actually, I need to go eat dinner right now, so... yeah.
Not last when you guys moved toward the dam to get a better position on that.
Drops.
I'll come back on later tonight after I eat.
Drops were supposed to be ending this afternoon.
Hopefully you guys made...
I don't know whether that did or did not happen. The fact that Twitch still has them on makes me think that we did not get them off
tonight. Hopefully I see you guys
later
tonight. You guys are still on.
Yep. I'll be on for at least another hour.
If you don't change your position on the map, that's why heal balls. People complain about heal balls because you can't find them properly. You gotta pay attention that way. Position is everything.
It's all right. We will have other opportunities in the future, and we'll probably change up the actual constituency of the drops. But we got it for them to have to be interesting. They have to. They can't always be on. Otherwise, they're not special. So we had these running, I think, for about 3 weeks, which is pretty good.
Everybody's asking about carriers on that deck stream.
Damn.
I just wish I was a little bit faster.
Full power to maneuvering thrusters.
Enemy vessel. Need support fire.
Oh, hey, Squire. He's all the way over there.
Yeah, this is my TAC cruiser.
Holy shit. So fast.
With the watcher
hey,
coding.
Dennis.
Yeah, what's up?
Stay near me and I'll weapon boost your beams.
Alrighty. Love it.
I'll turn that tickle beam into a Death Star beam.
I love Death Star beams. There are going to be builds like that. Oh shit, is that... Are those... Oh no, that's no good. I'm about to get catapulted.
Sniper range, probably.
What is it?
Engaging. System drained. Cycling.
Now to get some pods out. This won't. What I'm doing right now will not actually be doable in 113 in the same way.
Hi, Captain. Engaging. We can't. She's sending a repair pod. Reloading. Look.
Hi, Captain.
I'm tractored. Madness.
Left side.
Thank you for those heals. Oh no.
Yeah, he's. I'm not sure where you're trying to heal.
I got triple nailed. Wow, Owen hit me for 42,000 damage. That kind of hurt.
Thanks for. And have a good one, you guys. Thanks.
Thanks, Starcrust. Have a good one, man.
Yeah. Later I'm gonna write down the ideas I got here and submit.
Sounds good. Just hit me and drop them in Discord for me, and I'll pass them along.
Who's pushing me forward? Stop pushing me forward! God damn it!
I'm getting tractored, man.
Overclock pulse.
Hey, hell, I am that.
Damn it. Gotta get that.
You know what? I'm gonna have to,
catapult up.
Got a bearing on the enemy ship.
Prepare pod is away. Reloading pod launcher.
Head up this, sniper right there. God.
Somebody mark a target so we can focus fire.
Requesting fire at this location.
Oh, he did.
I just got purged.
That's okay. I'm right here in their faces.
Over there.
And of course.
Multiple impacts detected.
Luna does not want to go down.
There, she's down.
Heels over here. Under
Spartan and a Phoenix. Or at least the cosmetics thereof.
Not a bad build for the
captain. Enemy missiles incoming, Captain.
The advantage, Captain. Full power to maneuvering thrusters. Ships hull down to 50%, Captain.
Alright, on the way back right now.
Enemy vessel.
Firing up. We've got nothing left. Commencing cooldown.
Here we are.
Aye, Captain. Engaging.
Mandalore has no backup.
Prepare pod is away.
Reloading. Hi, Captain.
Oh my god.
Ah, it's that purge.
Time.
Thanks, Captain. Fire on this target.
Sniper on the right.
The Captain.
Oh man.
Starting to fold at this position.
This pod, I can't hit this pod right here. The pod race on this thing is so bad.
Got a bearing on the enemy ship.
Oh my god, all the healing.
Launching catapult. Warhead, aye, Captain.
Captain, we're getting butchered out there. We gotta step in.
God damn it.
Picking up enemy contact. Over there.
Amplifying weapons, aye.
Fuck, dude.
Bad shots.
Full power to maneuvering thrusters.
location. Stasis warheads targeting the enemy ship. Launching stasis warhead.
Oh damn it. Pick a target.
Enemy vessel.
Oh man, that is not what I meant to do. Man, 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 I evaded the wrong direction. Bad, bad, bad.
Wrong way.
Launching stasis warhead.
Damn it. I'm getting out sniped badly. FA-21's got the right idea.
What is Zandon doing?
All vessels, we've got an enemy contact. Firing catapult.
Just got purged.
Stasis warhead launched.
You got it. Firing thrusters.
Your frontliner tier 4 dreadnought. You want to follow me?
We've been hit hard. Damage control team's dispatched. Shield activated.
Bearing on the enemy ship. Fire thrusters. Hi, Captain. We have to regroup. Enemy vessel. Thanks for the assist. Launch stasis warhead.
We need to move out of there. Not in, out.
Launching catapult.
Abandoned ship. All hands.
There we go.
I did that terribly.
Could have gotten a little better.
Yes, that would be cool. Not my finest hour.
You got down for more?
Hell yeah.
I got time for one more as well. Just hungry as hell right now.
Jack's at 955 viewers.
Awesome.
No, he's not.
Well, because China.
China.
Yep. Hey, I'm at 13. Beat that.
Isn't that streaming under Dreadnought?
They can't use Twitch in China. He's using a different one.
How come?
It's blocked.
Oh, that's so stupid.
That's, hey, God, Chinese government, man.
I have
man.
No good chips for Elysium.
Like, that's it's slow.
Oh, man.
It's the same people over and over.
Yeah.
Somebody else want to pick up heels?
I'll do it. Oh, no.
I need to get armor booster pulls on my Jutland. Like, ASAP.
Josh?
Hey, hello.
Yeah, Hong Kong is good. Alright.
Here we go. All
allied ships be advised. I have a good feeling about this together. I feel like we're not gonna lose this bad.
Alright, head left side.
Well, left side.
Should be.
Burn. I can't hear you.
All the way.
Yes, I have your max. I'm on.
Really?
Me as well.
We could use some backup here.
Nuke's up.
Enemy warhead locked on our position.
Nuke on me. No one's got hell lasers or anything, that'd be lovely.
I turned it up a little bit.
That's a little better. You could turn it up more. I do that. I admittedly, I will definitely stasis the slowest goddamn ship.
I just got hit with it, and I just stasis.
Now you can't move.
I really can't move. Oh my god, why?
For the extra pain of not being able to move. Having been in a Jutland that's been stasis many times, I know how annoying it is, which is why I do it to other people. Lonely needs to die. Damn purge.
No. We're winning, Captain. Heaven's down. And that is a beautiful Earth strike right there.
Hey, Val, I could use some heals behind you.
We've been hit hard. Deploy damage control things.
Okay,
damn it. I'm being tractored.
Go over there.
Not cool on the tractor.
Head ups.
Repair auto beams activated. Float the pod, aye, Captain.
Got a bearing on the enemy ship.
System drain. Starting cooldown.
Does that
So the double stacked Tartaruses.
Oh, he's so close to dying too. There we go. Nice and done. Medic!
Shoot Luna. And switch to general. Purge nuke incoming.
Go away, Spartan! Oh my god!
I'm gonna switch if I can.
I had a Jack. While I was purge beating him.
We gotta kill Jack right there.
I don't get how that's possible. It must have like ticked off for a
second. Damn it, Jack just got two kills. He busted out the I win build. That's gonna get nerfed, Jack.
Stop hitting me with stasis, dude. I can't move anyway. Shit. Enough of it. Ah.
This is a horrible spot for the set, guys.
Our healers are out in the open, theirs are not. We should probably change that.
Heading on.
You guys wanna come up to this hill over here or something?
Hills are pretty, I like hills. Hills sound good. Did Jack get anyone there?
He got... one of us, I think.
Repair auto beams.
Aye, Captain. Engaging.
Repair pod system.
Picking up enemy contact. Over there.
Alright, I'm gonna... jump in on
Lonely Low. Only very low. Finish him.
That'd be great. Oh. I can't hit him from there. Ah, fuck.
Oof, nice.
Captain, you guys would like to pull back to some of our reconnections, like defense, but we're gonna lose if we don't.
Yeah.
You guys can't just sit out and move and expect to have the same result as them and in cover.
Full power to maneuvering thrusters.
All ships. Regroup.
Amplifying weapons, aye.
Hostile contact sighted.
God, how does he still... Okay.
Firing.
System drained. Cycling.
Enemy vessel.
Trying to keep Ahab up. Damn it, lost him.
Requesting fire over here.
Alright. Just regroup. Captain Stowe, very low. Get him, get him, get him, get him, get him. Nice.
Purge!
Aye, Captain.
Repair auto beams activated. Deploy repair pod, aye, Captain.
Reloading.
There we go.
Captain, we're gaining ground out there.
Yes, I'm good.
Enemy vessel.
Spartan. Incoming. And Jack incoming.
Enemy missiles incoming, Captain.
I'm just distracted.
Damage control team dispatched.
Thank you.
Did Jack kill two of us? He didn't get me.
Nope.
Rammers Inc. and Spartan Inc.
All vessels, yep, Jack, come back.
That side?
Scrambled.
Just got hit with the...
Ready for Jack, guys. Ready for Jack.
All ships, enemy contact. Ran by Luna.
Firing up. Reloading launcher. Stand by.
Nice shutdown on Luna.
Who is above me? I can't see shit right now.
I got Toshix. Spartan coming in again. Just tickle him a little, keep him away.
Got a bearing on the enemy ship.
Repair auto beams activated.
Enemy warheads locked on our position.
Lonely. Warheads Inc. If anyone's got anti-missile, it'd be lovely.
Up on
his... Hi, Captain. Engaging.
Jack is behind our team.
Activated.
Is he?
Yep, behind the hill. Tucked right up against that hill.
Picking up enemy contact.
I'm gonna keep an eye out then.
Captain, the pod's in place. Systems depleted, Captain.
Lonely low.
Full power to maneuvering thrusters.
Here comes Jack, purge beaming him. Go, 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 go. Hit him, hit him, hit him.
Can't hit him if I can't see him.
Nice, final blow. Spartan is coming in. Tickling him.
I may not be getting any
tickling
points from him. Purges, but I'm sure he's shutting him down.
Understood. Repairing. Deploy repair pod. I, Captain. Systems drained, Captain.
You're the boss. Requesting fire over here.
Here comes...
Deanne.
Oh, disrupted. Nice save, holy cow. I can't believe I'm alive. And now I'm getting purged.
We've been hit hard. Damage control team dispatched.
Perhaps a load.
Support fire. Need it over here. Enemy warheads locked on our position.
Nostrovo coming in.
Jack's coming in on us again.
Have someone here.
I feel like they're kind of serious at answers.
Rockets hurting.
Multiple impacts.
Jack.
He's got me on that one. That's alright, that's alright. He got that one. Yes, we should make a heavy Corvette here, shouldn't we? Jack's out. Skills.
All ships, enemy contact.
Right?
At this
yeah.
Location.
Oh, there it goes, Jack.
Starting recharge.
In the, cushion.
Nice job.
Whew. My neck!
You can bounce off the ground, Charlie. You absolutely can.
That was a rough match.
It
certainly was.
Those are the ones that are fun.
Yeah, I agree.
I just wish I got points for purging.
In the future, maybe. We're talking about putting in some scoring actions for that.
Sweet.
Damn it. Jack just snuck past me.
Know this email.
Good, how are you doing?
Pretty good for right now. I got like some kind of head cold or something, so I can't record anything. Decided just to make a teaser trailer.
Cool.
Bro.
I'm really worried that if I go into mid-range matchmaking, LYB will kick my ass again. Is there any way, like, I could avoid that?
Invite me to the squad.
Fox is unstoppable. Group with Fox. Yeah. That and most of LYB that's online right now is playing Legendary.
Okay, good.
Which is what's supposed to happen.
Ooh, his name Pop? I like that.
He's LYB, I had an experience with them a couple of times, and man, they just mop the floor with you without mercy. That's all that happens. It's ridiculous.
Yeah.
I normally do pretty good. I get around 11 kills. These dudes end me before I can do anything.
They're very skilled. Yes.
They have made tactics, or they have been actual ship commanders or something. Like, I don't know.
Yeah. Honestly, LYB is not the only bastion of good play in the game. There's actually several clans that are very, very skilled.
I mean, I'm not surprised that they're not the only bastion. However, they're still like the only one that's just ended me.
Yeah. Hey, don't feel their narcissism. Feel mine. Come on.
Okay, and Manabar, to answer your question, you're
but
solo
queue. I like this game. I like to play.
Oh, I see what you're asking.
I'm very new, actually.
You're asking, are we ever going to have
that you're proud of yet, or
a solo queue versus a group queue?
I've kicked
Hold on one
a
second.
Lot
Let me
of
step
ass
out of this.
Taken no...
To answer your question, the matching pools aren't large enough for us to be able to make those kind of calls. Basically, right now, I'll use Legendary as an example. When there's 16 people in the matching queue, it doesn't matter whether they're queued or not. There's no point. It doesn't matter what your MMR is, doesn't even matter what your fleet rating is. There's only 16 people to match against. So there's one. So matchmaking is something we're going to be looking at more post-Steam, when we actually have a larger base and a more clear insight as to what good matchmaking would look like there. And yes, we will take into account when there are groups, and we'll take into account when there are pugs. But they will never, almost certainly, will almost never have the matchmaking pool to be able to handle a solo-only queue and a group-only queue, I will bet you. I would love to be wrong. I would love to have a player base that large, but I just don't know if that's going to happen. Nailed. We'll see. It's not that I don't see the value in it, it's just that I don't know that we're ever going to have matching pools of one. We're just further and further slicing and dicing the matching pool. Remember, 75% of the people that are online at any one point in time or another are in a battle. That means they're not in the matching pool. And actually have good matching. I've seen some talks given at GDC by Bungie and the like. You need 40 times the number of people you need in a slot per matchmaking criteria in order to get good matches based upon an MMR system. 40 times. So 40 times 16 times 3 fleets. And then if you want to do solo and group queue separately, now you need to have 2 times that, because you've just doubled the number of matching pools. So, and the number, the way we'll never have that number of players. I mean, you literally need 10,000 people in a matching pool at any given time, and we don't have 10,000 peak concurrent today, and we probably won't at Steam levels.
What was our highest during the double EXP?
I didn't say no. Double EXP is not the highest. We've been much higher than that. But it was high. Double EXP. The nice thing about double XP is, Legendary High was the highest. And then somebody else is asking me about, there used to be lights flashing on some ships that no longer flash. Is that a bug? I'm not sure, Yomu. I haven't noticed. Or Yumu. I haven't noticed. Can you put in a bug on that? Just enter a bug in the bug request form.
Danny's way.
It might be. I haven't noticed whether we've lost lights or not.
Might have changed his dynamic light setting.
It could have. Well, we actually are removing a lot of the dynamic lights, specifically because they were massive performance hits, and that's part of how we're getting 8v8 on PlayStation, as an example. Jesus, too much healing going on. I gotta kill some healers. Also need to pay attention more. Yeah, that's exactly right. It's hard to, like, our channel was so loud.
Yeah, it's nice and quiet in here.
Oh, I'm being terrible. The team's healing well.
Full power to maneuvering thrusters.
We're locked on. Stasis warhead's got a lock, Captain. Thanks.
Assist.
Enemy warheads lock on our position. Enemy vessel. Launching stasis.
Aye, Captain. Engaging.
Oh, now the once. Kill Jack Zhao.
Got a bearing on the enemy ship.
Full power to maneuver.
Are you on my team or their team?
I'm on opposite team.
Boo you.
We've taken the lead, Captain.
Firing catapult.
Oh no, Spartan.
There you
go, sir. You got it. Firing thrusters.
We still don't have maneuvering thrusters.
Ships hold down to
50. Ah. Okay.
Is it intentional for torpedoes not to have, like, one reticule put in?
I'm sorry, say again?
Is it intentional that torpedoes don't have, like, missile warning red signs?
For, like, Goliaths, you mean?
Well, any torpedoes in general, they don't have them.
I think they're meant to not, because they don't have any major lock.
Okay.
Their lock is much lower.
Yeah, sort of. Proximity locking, I guess.
Yeah, and they're dumb. They're mostly dumb.
Picking up enemy contact.
They fly to the last, to the first known location of the target. They don't track well, so I don't know that they're... I mean, I don't know why Yeager meant that call, but... frankly, I don't mind it.
Yeah, it's a nice difference. You can let me need to pay attention to it.
Yep. And you can see them, they tend to be more visible.
Oh, yeah.
At least Goliaths do.
Thanks for the assist. Hostile contact sighted. Stasis warheads targeting the enemy ship.
Amplifying weapons, aye.
Support fire. Meet it over here. We're locked on. Launching stasis warhead. Got an enemy contact. Launching catapult.
Amplifying weapons, aye.
They want Olga to stay up. I don't. Nice.
Full power to maneuvering thrusters. We're taking them down, ship by ship.
It's close.
Gotta keep it there.
Stasis warhead locked in at the ready. Launch stasis warhead, aye, Captain.
Oh no, I just clipped the stupid asteroid.
Jack's at 1,200 now.
He's a beast.
Got a bearing on the enemy ship. Launch stasis warhead, aye, Captain.
Recharging pulse countermeasures. Stand by.
warheads locked on our position.
Oh no. I got nuked. I got stasis and nuked. Or purged and nuked something. And Manabara, actually, I can't see us rewarding solo play. That is the antithesis of what we want to see. I could see us rewarding group play.
Jack's probably going to go free.
Yeah, I see him.
Man, you had a bad spawn. What is that?
That happens. Jack's taking pity on me. He ran away. Yeah, that's what I thought. ETN voice, we'll be evaluating probably towards the end of the year.
The enemy's recovering. We can't let them turn it around.
Enemy vessel, recharging generator.
Hey, hey, don't tell me to slice you.
Come here. Come here.
Hi, Captain. Engaging.
There you go, you little sneaker.
Captain, we're gaining ground out there. Engaging.
System drained. Cycling. Full power to maneuver.
Yeah, towards the end of the year, and we're probably looking at actually doing exactly what I said we shouldn't do, and that is possibly going for a paid solution, the same one that we're using on PlayStation, so that in the event we ever get to crossplay, we can have everybody in the same voice solution.
Fire on this target. Aye, Captain.
Float the pod. Aye, Captain.
Reloading. Still charging the pulse generator, Captain.
Engaging.
Regroup. I repeat, let's regroup.
Activated.
Damn it, Jack. Oh, I'm not even gonna dent him.
Multiple impacts. Damage control teams on station.
Nah, he's too beefy. Manabura, I don't understand how everyone doesn't have the luxury of clans or friends. In the sense that, yes, I realize that lots of people solo queue, but we can... you can meet people... I mean, everyone that I'm playing with right now are people I've met in-game. And frankly, it doesn't matter whether I'm playing our game or other people's games. I always happen to make acquaintances... like-minded individuals who play during my hours that I group with repeatedly. Doesn't mean everyone has to. It's not a requirement. But it's not an insurmountable thing, or at least shouldn't be.
Close enough. There you go.
Yeah. Boo. And you know, we want to encourage socialization. We want to encourage social bonds between players who may not know each other in real life. That's definitely something that keeps people coming back and playing, is making online friends. So if anything, I could see us rewarding squatting, just as pretty much most games do.
ETN custom games by chance?
113.
Cool.
And then you guys can do clan battles and all that fun stuff, so... yeah, custom games will be in 113 for PC.
Good. Need it for training purposes?
Yep. Or yes, you can goof around and mess with builds and set up all sorts of shenanigans. You can say, hey, everybody coming in, we're doing nothing but slice wars. It's Corvettes with assault blank only. I don't know. Whatever you want.
Oh, yeah. A ram jousting.
Yes, ram jousting. You got it. All sorts of goofiness can occur.
We just need Tony Norvez to come back for Tony Ball.
We haven't seen him in ages.
I haven't seen him in a while either.
Tony Ball could be a mode.
He should just have like a command ship as a potato and something. There was one I planned out for Rings of Saturn. The goal points would be at the opposite ends of the ring. We have to like push them through it to the other end. That's the field.
That is funny. But yeah, voice wise, we're probably going to use a Vivox solution, like Fortnite does, because it allows for cross-platform chat. But it costs money for us, not for you guys. For us, it's not like Steam Voice or Discord. We could integrate with no cost. You know, PlayStation voice chat, we could use at no cost. But we're probably going to make a larger play towards a cross-platform solution eventually, in the hopes that someday we get there. And we may have other platforms to talk about in the future as well. I hope to. Yeah. Sure. So it's funny. So Bacon just said Switch confirmed. I'm almost positive that Fortnite and Paladins will be announced for Switch next week.
I mean, I'm already playing the Paladins mobile game. It's okay, but...
Yeah, it's solid.
I was surprised that it even got there.
Yeah, Hi-Rez does good work. I actually, you know, I know a bunch of guys over there. They do really good work. We're actually trying to do... I view 6 foot as being Hi-Rez-ish in our scope and scale, hopefully within three or four years. But we need a couple more games out to sort of catch up to them and to try and get a revenue base and a foundational set of services that are scalable at that level. Right now, trying to make everything work on a single title is really hard financially. As a matter of fact, it's impossible. We need more titles. That's going to be imperative. The economies of scale just don't work that way. Unless you're Riot or Wargaming, it just doesn't work that way. And even Wargaming doesn't work that way. Me too, Metabara. Me too. I'm working on it on multiple fronts.
Don't forget their bit mining.
Yes, exactly. I wish that were true too. Just a few cycles here and there.
The hangar is an illusion.
Mm-hmm. Sure it is. The new hangar's fast. The new UI is slick. It's very quick. Everything from mouse over here is kind of slow, and you know, it's loading weird things, and you've got all these dudes down here are all full poly, full feature, and you'll see it hitching. You know, every texture in here is a 4K texture. Every light in here is dynamic. And there's lots of geometry you can't see that still has draw calls. There's like all sorts of asteroids and stuff out there that have all sorts of draw calls associated with them.
What's going on?
Yeah.
That whole last match didn't have any bots in it.
Unless we lost more than two people.
Well, even if we lost two, then it would put bot replacements out.
Yeah, I said more than two. Yeah, oh, that's right. It could lose four. Yeah, okay, there it goes. Some people were buying modules, I guess. That wouldn't actually compromise no pay to win. It would be no, because you're paying for progression. It's nothing that you're not buying power. You're buying accelerated progression, which technically we kind of sell already, except not XP. That's the one thing. We want people to play the game. We don't want people to just sort of pay their way to Tier 5. That's part of the reason why there's no Tier 5 hero ships. We want Tier 5 to be reserved for those who have made the effort to play the game.
Two bots. Yeah, some people dropped that, it looks like.
Yep.
Two bots per team.
It's a couple. I got probably two more games in me.
Yeah, it's 12, 30-ish over here.
I mean, we allow for... paying to accelerate progression. We allow for, obviously, cosmetics and vanity and all that fun stuff. And we want to give more ways for people to express their own styles and things like that and show them off. And we're going to provide more opportunities for that.
Yeah, the Chinese streamer account so I can talk to his viewers.
Cool.
Kind of weird because like there's a level up system. Like I'm only level 0 and I can only put in 20 letters.
That's cool.
I kind of like it.
No, I totally get that. That actually is rad. So we used to have, we were thinking about systems when I was at Capcom for our community site for, hey, you can't post until you have a certain level of trust, period. You can't ask questions in the Ask Capcom forum until you have a certain level of trust.
Good against trolls.
Exactly, and just people making Smurf accounts or what have you to sort of, they want their... They want their thing, their point made, so they're going to make 6 accounts to say the same thing to make it look like there's lots of people who care about that one thing. Which happens more times than I would care to admit. Are you on my team or are you on their team?
I'm not. It's going to put us on opposite teams because we're in 2 different spots.
Oh, yep. Rick C on me. No bueno. Oh man, I gotta do 19,000 damage to dude before he dies.
Scratch another
nice.
Confirmed. Enemy dreadnought destroyed.
Full power to maneuvering thrusters.
You're the boss.
Float the pod, aye, Captain.
Got an enemy contact.
Systems depleted, Captain. Full power to maneuvering thrusters.
Are changing the starting spawn points on the maps ever been like an idea across the like the whoever does the maps or mountain?
I'm sorry, say again?
Changing the starting points.
I'm not sure how they're done on the maps. I think there's set positions or set like zones, but I don't know the logic of how it works.
Well, like if we're playing capture base right now, I've usually always seen it that we spawn. Well, we're on this side, you're in the open field plane area, not from like one of us spawns in the ocean, one of us spawns near the dam. You know what I mean?
Yep. Yep.
And from my perspective, I feel like. You have a nice, beautiful map, and you really get to see a good majority of it, so it's sort of like a waste. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Plus, it's nice in terms of, like, it just brings a whole new light to the map, because you get a whole new dynamic of strategy when you first start off.
So, actually, so here's someone saying some interesting stuff on the stream that I want to respond to in a second. Wow, what are you using for a build?
Me?
Yeah.
Blackwing.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I guess those work. They're better now than they used to be.
Support fire. Still need a bit more tuning to be competitive with other stuff. Aye, Captain.
Starting recharge. Hostile contact sighted.
Systems drained, Captain.
They are a lot of fun, though. That's why I like to use them.
They are. They're flashy. Thus the flash points. I am. That won't work in 113. Actually, it will work for it will work for arty pods. It will not work for repair pods. The hard cap on repair pods will be in place in the next update.
Somebody's shaming us on your stream.
Yeah, I'll explain in a minute. Well, to be fair, you guys, as I mentioned, play, you know, don't stomp. No one minds a close game. People mind when it's a shutout. And you, don't get me wrong, you get this. There are some folks in your guild that have not yet, they have not yet gotten the gospel that is that. No, I got double nuked. That's some bullshit. So Matabara, you're right, and the place where Steam will help a lot is those guys should never be in vet. They should always be in legendary. The problem is the legendary pool still isn't quite large enough. I think another double XP weekend, this last double XP weekend, we have a lot more legendary players routinely, and legendary queues pop pretty much every night. Once Steam is around, we have 10 times the number of players, and yes, it's going to take them some time to move up through the tiers, but eventually there'll be non-stop legendaries. There'll be no need. Those guys don't want to be in vet any more than you guys want them there. They would much rather be earning more XP and more credits in legendary than playing vets. It's true for not just LYB, all of them. All the clans don't want to be playing veteran, but that's...
if we set up the match and I'm spawning all the way back here and you spawn, like, maybe 2,000 meters behind you. Firing up. System drain. Hi, Captain. All ships when the match starts, instead of the open field on opposite end.
Yep. Oh my god, Kill Valiant. Finally, got him. Jesus. And double nuked again? But I live this time. And I got somebody trying to snipe me. Not cool.
Who?
It's the bot. It's Myra trying to snipe me.
You should be killing them.
Oh. I'm not in range. Jack is low. Jack is no longer low.
This is not looking good, Captain.
No, this is not looking good.
Healers?
Oh, do no, we have healers?
You have two Kataros, that's why.
I'm not even Kataro.
Oh, well, Illusion's playing Ninja Katara.
Oh, I'm about to get lit up. Oh, I'm dead. Oh, I thought Luna was one of our good guys. Five days, Crafty. You're new to the game. Love it. Love the new blood.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't really see any killers from the start of the thing.
Yeah, we had the wrong composition to start there.
Just came down to team comp at the start.
Yep. It's all good. I got time for one more game.
Yeah. So you know how Overwatch has that thing where when you're on the character selection screen, it says we need this, we need that. Like, we're missing a healer, we're missing a support.
Yes.
Having something like that?
We do have something like that, but it's not, it requires some interpretation. What we tell you is how many of each class you have, not you need this class, it's XYZ thing. So, that's a little tricky because the other thing that we can't tell today is how you've built your ship. What's the build? Because different ships can play different roles depending upon how they're built.
Yeah. And what's more, I'm guessing the algorithm's going to involve what models are set on that.
Well, yes, but it's trickier in that. Let's put it this way: you may be bringing in an anti-ram build because you're counter picking against what you think they're going to do based upon their comp. Yeah. I don't know that any algorithm we have is going to make that recognition. It's not. My point being is, it's not as simple as you need tank, you need a healer, you need more DPS. Because I mean, you may bring in an Arty, but your Arty may have disrupt auto beams, and so your DPS is not a real Arty in that regard. Crafty, you'll get there.
I mean, you could sort of have it like when you hover over your ally's portrait. Like, let's say if they're using this module set, it sort of labels their combination of modules as like a hybrid.
Possible. But I mean, let's put it this way. We have so many bigger fish to fry before we get to that. That's a nice to have, not a... We've got, I shit you not, our backlog of 75 things, of which we're going to get to maybe 8 this year post-Steam. It's big, and lots of stuff are things that provide I'll say working through tech debt or building new systems that allow us to iterate faster or that allow us to create content more quickly. Yeah, yeah. So it's still lots of reworking to do. In the long run, we're going to be a lot better, and I'd like to think that we're making I know we're making faster and faster progress, but it takes time. Yep, it's a marathon. All right, we got two healers. Yolanda rocking the Necron.
Go and translate some Chinese stuff for the Dreadnought community that he has over there. Yeah. So.
Well, I saw the thing you sent me from Yuyuman. Yeah. That was, and I sent that to the whole player relations team. I'm like, this
he did
is
that
awesome.
Whole thing, and he ended up getting barraged with a bunch of questions.
It's super amazing. And yeah, so I mean, and those guys hopefully will have, we'll have full Chinese in the build in 1.13.
Yeah, that's what they told me, and that's what they're waiting for. Otherwise, you'd see a lot more Chinese players.
I'm sure. Well, we actually have a fair number already. And once we get the Steam, I honestly think China is going to be our number one territory in terms of player base, like, overnight.
Without a doubt. I mean, if Dax started getting this many viewers compared to us, it's going to be intense when they come in. It's gonna be a lot of fun too, because I've already been observing like the playstyle and metas that each country brings. Like,
they're good. I'm telling you, the Russians and the Chinese are gonna completely change the dynamic of the community.
Yeah, I love fighting RHB. Okay. They're really fun to play against.
They are. So Crafty, I'll tell you. So Crafty says, I used to say I hate PvP. I just don't know what makes this different. I think I can tell you what it is.
Send out the pulse.
Don't leave you alone.
You're leaving me alone.
Amplifying weapons,
I could have sliced you.
You could have.
You know this build.
I do know this build too well. I've been on the receiving end of it too often.
Is this build getting looked at, by the way?
Yes, it is. It is getting looked at. But actually, we're looking more at medium tax, not to fix, but to try and probably make them a little bit better, to give them a more specific role, because there's very few cases where you would pick a medium over a light.
Tack, you said?
Yeah. No, not tack. Corvette. Medium Corvette. Yeah. Hey, 10 cent. Tencent does, actually, I know I have a lot of friends whose companies have had equity placed by Tencent. They're really good partners. They stay out of your business. They just want to participate. They're solid. And they are the 800-pound gorilla when it comes to, I'll say, footprint in China, if we wanted that. Now, we did have a Chinese partner lined up in the past. For reasons I won't get into, we have moved away from that.
Amplifying weapon systems.
My god, die.
Weapon amplifier.
Understood. Swapping to primary weapons, Captain. Just down an artillery cruiser.
Sending pulse. Ship is damaged, Captain.
Understood, enemy vessel.
Shield activated.
I can't believe that. Yeah. Oh, and I'm sorry, I got disconnected. I got distracted with the why it's better. I think the pace of PvP here being, it's not a Twitch game. There's plenty of action, but it's not a joysticks, gyrations, gymnastics game. It's all about strategy and positioning, and it's like a real-time strategy game as a shoot, disguised as a shooter.
Just don't like to pick the Medusa, the Brunline in general.
It's not that people don't like to. It's just that it doesn't fit a role that's any different than, other than 360 firing. It's not necessarily a better option than than a light.
I mean, most, from what I've seen, most people just don't know how to use the ship in general. Because the light ones are a lot easier to light. Kind of just go in, it's like a strafing run ship. You know what I mean? The medium one's more of a kiting, like dancing around, kiting.
It can be, but it's harder to use for that reason. And it's in terms of its efficacy versus lights, it's or heavies, it doesn't fit as well. So that's yeah.
I mean, for the role that I found best in, that's why the only real viable thing they use is the target warp, but 360 kiting.
Yeah.
It's just too slow otherwise. It's sort of in the same pool as like the Jellin in terms of like speed, 360 firing.
Yep. 360 firing is nice. That is a nice change. Oh jeez, what is going on?
Amplifying weapons, aye.
I just did that all wrong. I did not have a lock there. Oh, is that gonna hit anyone?
Once all the models are like retuned so that more of them are viable, it might change the way that works for the medium, but anyway.
It's possible. But and that's one of the things we have to sort of look at things in. There's a sequence of things that we need to look at them at. No, and Manabara, they don't. So my friends at Epic, my friends at Riot, they're just purely along for the ride financially. They're not there to put any sort of strategy inside. Wow, what is going on over there? We just lit like four of that team up. We just broke their heal ball.
Stuff.
We got him, Captain.
That is bad. That's not gonna work.
Good night. Scratch one dreadnought.
Make it pretty to assault blink warp in any direction. I don't think that's. Yeah, don't get wrong, Assault Blink Warp is already a high-skill module.
Hostile contact sighted. Full power to maneuvering thrusters. We need some support. Amplifying weapons, aye. Weapon amplifier drained, Captain.
Probably help if I actually didn't shoot the rocks.
We've got this battle in the bag. Let's finish him. Enemy missiles incoming, Captain. Amplifying weapon systems. We've been hit hard. Deploy damage control teams.
Activating primary.
And those are east. Now I'm gonna get killed here.
Amplifying weapon. Shield activated.
Give somebody a boost.
Critical systems going dark. No. We're losing
her. Related question, how long before EA goes away? I wouldn't make a prediction that they will. I'm sorry, say again, Spartan?
For like your new viewers, if you got any.
See a few
I don't recognize.
There's a few. Feel free to toss a couple out.
I gave a couple of Jack as well for his people.
Good, good.
Requesting assistance.
Yeah. Kyle's gonna be working with Jack to Jack will make his official status this week, I believe Kyle said.
Help
him with his overlays. What's he using, OBS?
Yeah, OBS. I'm not sure if you've noticed, but I have like all of the skin that's uniform that pretty much like the associate one with like a certain color path. For Dreadnought at least.
Enemy destroyer, destroyed, Captain.
Alrighty. And on that note, are you streaming right now?
No.
Okay, I was gonna say who's
one LB stream at a time. Unless it's like a big event, then it'd be awesome.
Let's see who we're gonna raid here. I could do auto psychotic.
Usually stays up the whole time. I think he usually plays this whole morning, doesn't he?
He plays like 18 hours a day. It's kind of crazy.
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out what's going on there.
So I'm going to... I don't know how he does it. I don't have that kind of stamina.
No, I don't have the time either. So.
That's okay, Manabar. There's good stuff still coming. Otto is awesome. You'll like him. He's one of our streaming partners.
Okay. Let's see if there's any people I don't recognize. Crafty Sermon.
He just started playing
five days ago?
5 days ago, yeah. Sounds like he's in need of a code.
Yeah, I'll send him a code.
I will see you guys tomorrow.
Yeah, and who's gonna message me concerning the thing we've done?
Kyle. Kyle will get you under NDA. So.